In simple terms, the shadow can be defined as the container for all the rejected parts of the ego, whatever parts of the personality that would ordinarily belong to the ego, if repressed, falls into the shadow. Hence, the shadow has an immoral or at least a disreputable quality, containing features of a person's nature that are contrary to the customs and moral conventions of society. The specific contents and qualities that go into making up the shadow are selected by the process of the ego development. What ego consciousness rejects becomes shadow. What it positively accepts and identifies with and absorbs into itself becomes a part of itself and of the persona. The shadow works in the dark. It carries out its activities without the ego's knowledge. Hence, the shadow is not experienced directly by the ego. The common way of encountering the shadow is via projection onto some other individual or group. This means what I see in others that I dislike is something which I am struggling with myself unconsciously. For instance, when one is tremendously irritated by a really egotistical person, that reaction is usually a signal that an unconscious shadow element is being projected. These projections can be onto external others or onto internal dream figures or both. The shadow and the persona are like two persons inside an individual. One is out in public and the other is hiding away and reclusive. To an ego that has strongly identified with the persona, the shadow is seen as pure evil. If a person completely shuts the shadow, life is proper, but it is terribly incomplete. But the encounter with the shadow gives him new energy, although he becomes tainted with immorality, but attains a greater degree of wholeness. Often, the shadow is not as evil as the ego imagined it to be. Jung talks a lot about the integration of the persona and the shadow. What he means by the integration is self-acceptance, of fully accepting those parts of oneself that belongs both to the persona and to the shadow. The assimilation of the shadow leads to self-acceptance and self-forgiveness. Jung quotes a letter from a former patient written sometime after he saw her for analysis. It says, "Out of evil, much good has come to me. By keeping quiet, repressing nothing, remaining attentive, and by accepting reality, taking things as they are and not as I wanted them to be. By doing all this, unusual knowledge has come to me, and unusual powers as well, such as I could never have imagined before. I always thought that when we accepted things, they overpower us in some way or other. This turns out not to be true at all, and it is only by accepting them that one can assume an attitude towards them. So now I intend to play the game of life, being receptive to whatever comes to me, good and bad, sun and shadow, forever alternating, and in this way, also accepting my own nature with its positive and negative sides. Thus, everything becomes more alive to me. What a fool I was, how I tried to force everything to go according to the way I felt it ought to."